People ask me, how hard was it really? I show them these pictures. I'm doing sports all my life. I have an encyclopedic knowledge about biochemistry, nutrition, and training. I know what I'm doing, brother. I have willpower that cannot be broken. Mentally, I'm very strong. I experienced a lot of things in life, man. Life hardened me up. I had obstacles and challenges in my life. They made me a very tough, conditioned, perseverant, and loyal human being. I won't let anyone behind, especially I won't let myself down. But in these pictures, you see how hard it really was for the body. Without oxygen, without food, climbing 18 hours for 3 days in a row by now. Head and eyes swollen. Headache that strong that you think your head is exploding. You cannot sleep because your resting heart rate is at 150 and you think that your heart is going to stop any minute. Don't forget, while others rested, I also needed to support all my clients in the meantime. From base camp to high camp in 3 days, I already lost around 10 kilograms of body weight, and that's a lot for me. No proper sleep, maybe only 1 hour per night each. The mountains eat you up. No oxygen, brother. Your body is going crazy. You go crazy. But ahead of me is the final day. We call it Summit Push or Summit Day. I kept telling myself, brother, you're already at high camp. You paid nearly $100,000 for all of this endeavor. You're in Antarctica, in one of the most distant places on Earth. I kept asking myself, brother, will you really allow that you return to civilization and then you have to tell everyone that you did not manage to go up the mountain, that you were too weak, that you were a fucking pussy? This was no option at all. I'd rather die, literally. There was no fucking chance that I give up. Giving up is not an option for me. I won't let others down, but most importantly, I won't let myself down. Self-respect, brother.
Ну вот подняли штурмовой лагерь, все классно, с погодой повезло, поставили лагерь, палатки, в общем, круто, сейчас будем расчехляться и варить снег, топить снег. Фу, подустали немного.
Wind of east, 10 to 15 knots.
It was summit day. I hyped myself mentally. Mount Everest has around 10,000 successful summits. Mount Vinson around 1,200. I constantly told myself, in 24 hours, you will be a legend. Every hour that went by, in 23 hours, you will be a legend. This mantra I had in my head all the way up, every single step. I also asked myself, what would my idols do? What would Michael Jordan do? What would Zeus do? What would Kobe Bryant do? None of them would surrender, that's for sure. So I did not surrender. I was so focused on the summit push that I do not remember much of the climb, to be honest. Not much filming, no selfies, no distraction. Every single iota of energy I kept to myself. I did not even have energy to speak much. My head shut down. It was the only mantra on low oxygen and crazy exhaustion. Every step the mantra. In 18 hours you will be a legend. In 17 hours you will be a legend. In 17 hours you will be a legend. In 17 hours you will be a legend.
Так, идем полтора часа. Подошли к первому пихолу. Вот он, первый пихол. Для тех, кто не помнит, напоминаю, пихол — это специально отведенное место, куда надо справлять нужду по-маленькому. И заодно возле пехолов мы отдыхаем. Так, против солнца, конечно, но попробую показать наш вообще маршрут. Вот перед нами, собственно говоря, массив Винсон, его вершина. Вот так мы сейчас идем через ледник. Прямо чуть-чуть, возможно, забирая немножечко правее, подходим под вершинный массив. И вдоль склона по снежному склону идем вот сюда-сюда-сюда налево. Доходим до этой точки. Здесь снова поворачиваем направо. Идем вверх-вверх-вверх. И там немножечко за горой уже выходим на гребень. И с той стороны по гребню обходим, доходим до вершины. Все, надеюсь, у нас все получится.
When we reached the ridge, I understood that now you have to be careful. Now it is life and death. One wrong step, you fall down kilometers and no one is ever going to find you. It was so dangerous, steep and narrow that at some point you could not stand with parallel feet. On the side you have an abyss that goes down 2 kilometers. And all this while nearly blacking out, being without oxygen, food and sleep. But then I saw the summit in the distance of the ridge and my adrenaline rushed. I was very close to reach the summit of Antarctica's highest mountain, Antarctica's highest point, Mount Vinson.
Made it to the summit. No comments. There's the summit. Mount Vinson. It was hardcore. Right now, lost for words. I had no power to film during the ascent because I needed everything. Guys, we made it. Now we have to get down. This is only half time. And then I will make a proper video. This is just proof that I was here. Anyways, guys, thanks for the support. This was hard.
When I reached the summit, I will tell you honestly, the most prominent feeling of this minute was the following. It was relief. Relief that I made it to the summit and could cope with the best mountaineers of the world. I felt relief because I proved people wrong, who said it's too dangerous, it's too crazy, it's too hard for you to do Vinson as the first mountain. Happiness and joy I did not feel yet, because I knew from the professionals who told me that the most casualties, around 80%, happen on the way down. When there is no more adrenaline, when there is no more gas in the tank, when people leave all the energy for summit push but are too exhausted to come down. So I did not waste energy on emotions. At the summit, the mountain gods blessed us with perfect weather. It was minus 65 degrees Celsius, coldest temperature I was ever exposed to in my life. But the view, it was so beautiful, words cannot describe it. There was a special moment, no camera, no talking, no selfies. Everyone just sat down and thought about something. A moment. These 15 minutes where I just sat down, just watched the infinity of Antarctica, I just thought about life, thought about myself, thought about my work, thought about my purpose, a magical moment that I will keep to myself for the rest of my life.
Now the mission is complete, I have no voice. Yesterday it was summit, you have seen me at the summit. After this I was knocked out. It was an 18-hour climb up and down. And then I went to bed, I felt really, really bad. Then from summit to high camp, I felt really bad. And then we went from today from high camp low camp, from low camp to base camp in one go. Also, all the long, around 14 hours. So now we are at base camp. Now finally, mission complete. It was hardcore. I gave it all. I have no words. It was hardcore. Now we're going to drink champagne. Guys, thank you for all your support. 3 months preparation. I'll etch that all out there. Now it's time to rest and get a massage. I go drink some champagne, guys.
Поэтому, Никит, это крутое начало, не останавливайся на достигнутом. Мужик, где бы ты там ни жил, у тебя настоящий мужик, казак. Короче, Никитос, красавчик, без трон.
As I expected, the descent was even harder than going up. And going up was damn hard, trust me. At some point, the oxygen was so low and exhaustion so high that I just needed to lay down on the ice. I'm a very humble, down-to-earth and friendly person who cherishes the small things in life. I mean, my job is to help people all around the world. For example, you get really humbled when you work with cancer patients or someone who has a very strong disease. You start to think about life. You start to think about the small things. You start to appreciate life a lot. After this expedition, after these days where the only thing you want is just some oxygen, just a warm meal or just a small sip of warm tea, you get really humbled, brothers and sisters. Life gets a new meaning for you. This expedition changed the course of my life forever.
Guys, I'm here with the one and only Nymphs from 14 Peaks Netflix documentary. Please check it out. Nymphs, we are here two record holders, you know why? Because you made 14 Peaks in 7 months. And I'm the first man on this planet whose his first mountain is Vinson. No one ever does it.
You know, like, huge congratulations, brother, and to everyone who is watching the movie 14 Peaks. Big thank you for your support. And those who have watched it, make sure you watch it, because it's not about only climbing, it's about dreaming big, it's about believing in yourself, in your vision, and having the bigger purpose to change the world for the better region. Big thank you and huge congratulations on your summit, brother.
When I went up to Vinson, I had the movie in my mind.
Boom.
No give up, just go up, go up.
Yeah,
go up.
Giving up is not in the blood.
Not in the blood. Yeah. Altitude sickness, exhaustion, I was like this, oh, where am I? Just keep on pushing.
Wow.
Just keep
awesome,
on pushing.
Brother. Everyone, much love.
Guys, I'm here with Tashi and Dava. My first mountain was Vinson. His first mountain.
Everest.
Maybe my second mountain will be Everest too. What do you think? Can I manage Everest?
You're the guy. You can do everything at once. If there is something you have to do.
I think we have to do it. First mountain Vinson, second mountain Everest. Maybe, who knows? Tashidava, real expert. How many times have you been on Everest?
Nine times.
Nine times? Yeah, and you?
Three times.
Three times. Yeah. 12 times Everest combined. That's crazy. Me, one time, Vinson. Very nice guys. Guys, this was NIKIBRAH from Antarctica, the last scenes. Mission completed, we made it. First person whose first mountain is Mount Vinson. Antarctica is such a beautiful place. Now we'll board our plane, check it out. I hope you enjoyed Antarctica Nikki vlog from Mount Vinson. And this was me. Thanks for the support. Thanks for viewing. See you next time. Next expedition. Who knows? I think it's going to be Everest, guys. It's going to be Everest. We need to risk it to get the biscuit for us. That's it. Next is Everest. Take care, guys. No more mountain virgin.
Come on.
I wanna live.
would give. Me searching for a pot of gold, and I'm getting old. Keep me searching for a pot of gold.
All you heart of gold, my dear.
For a heart of gold.
You got it, brother. Heart of gold right there.